What's up, everybody? I just jumped the rabbit. Me and my new puppy, a 13-week-old puppy, just jumped the rabbit. Me and him just walked through the woods and he jumped it. And so I took out Beast to follow him. And he can run him out for me. But I'm so tired of that puppy. Me and him just walked into the woods. And he starts barking. And right in front of him, a little rabbit jumps up. Okay, guys. Beast still run him out for me. I'll get another shot at him. And so after he jumped him, I brought the puppy back. This little guy, he's the one that jumped my rabbit. Thanks, buddy. If I get a kill, I'll post a picture for you guys. And I'll probably take and tie a string to that rabbit's leg and let him run it. I'll keep you guys updated with that. Well, everybody, Beast finished him off for me. He took him a little bit, this rabbit, doing a couple of loops. And Beast finally, after he finally would do his check and catch him, he'd go straight back to him. I shot him. Just so happened I was watching Beast teach. I'll show you guys how he ran. But the thicket that comes right behind my dog pen, this rabbit's pretty smart. He ran all the way down this to the far corner of this field. Came back this way. This is way before Beast even got on the trail with him. Well, before we got into this field. When I took Beast over there, where I jumped, the puppy jumped the rabbit, he took off from there. I watched him. But Beast didn't see him. He was on the other side of kind of like a little structure we got out of there. So we didn't see him. But he ended up in here. He ran through this green straw and he went around the other side. And he hopped out once and stopped. And I only seen him when he hopped. And once he hopped, I went ahead and threw my gun up because I know we weren't about to take off real fast. And Beast was hot on his tail. Beast might have been 15 yards behind. And Beast is still going to check, and he's the one that caught the rabbit. he came out right about somewhere in this here little spot. But it's, he jumped once, he stopped, and I shot him in the head and knocked him down. And he was still kind of stunned, so he was still flopping around. And Beast got to him before I could, and Beast was grabbing him and shaking him. So I had to take him from him. I'm gonna put Beast up. And when I put Beast up, I'm tie a string to that rabbit and drag him around and work with that puppy a little bit. And hopefully I'll get some video of that. Practice makes perfect, right? Puppy's already taken that liking to him. I put him next to him, he's just trying to grab him for the fence. I know Beast ain't got on another rabbit. I only seen the one. He might be though. I want to take you guys where this rabbit was bedded at. And where the puppy jumped him. Alright. Since I don't do too much deer hunting, I did some this year. It's the most I've done. So I went to the truck camp. These season went out. I haven't had it in the woods. I've had it pointing for rabbits, trying to spot rabbits around my house and other little areas like that. Cause I have my trail camera set up on this bucket to point right here where I have my trap, my green trap. There are fresh rabbit turds on it. It's been a day or two, and I don't know. I think you have to come and check this, open this thing at least once a day for it to stay on for more than one day. Because if I leave it alone for 2 days, it's off when I come out here and it misses the old action. So I'm not really sure what's going on with it. I need to check back into the manual and check on it. But I'm gonna show you guys where this rabbit was bedded. He found a new bed spot. I take that back. This bed might have been here for a little while. I don't really come in here that much. When I do, I'm just shaking stuff up over here. This rabbit was bedded right next to this tree and those sticks. And so when I was stepping up earlier to come across here, the rabbit jumped up and started hopping that way. I think he's also, there's some possums and other stuff in this tree. Cause there's a, yeah, I don't know, that hole's really not big enough. But that's where this rabbit was bedding, right here in this hole. He's pretty smart. He's, I don't know if he made this or he just dug under and pushed the stuff up. Like I told you guys, when I got Beast over here, he smelt this spot. He was working around in it. There's another spot that rabbit could have been laying. So that's probably his day spot and his night spot. Ain't no telling. But when I jumped the rabbit, he come from here. I know. He didn't come from here. I would have seen him from over there. I just seen him through here. So he might have been under this tree. He came and he just walked right into here. This is the structure I was telling you guys about. It's an old hog pen. We used to have a big old boar up in here years ago. When he come in, when he started getting real physical with some pigs and stuff, we had to lock him up in here. When Beast finally got right here, he stepped in here and the rabbit took off outside. And in here, I could see him going across back across the field. And when I started the video back there for you guys, that's when you seen Beast really hitting on the trail good. I'm not gonna mess up that spot. Maybe that's another rabbit's bed. Could be. Might be a breeding pair. I need to check the sex of this rabbit. Last one I killed was a female. Had no testicles. At least I couldn't find any when I skinned it or felt it. So I'm gonna go check this one. People tell me that's the only way you can really tell if a rabbit male or female. So far, it's the only way I've found. And it's kind of hard to tell sometimes. But you really have to, I guess you really have to know what you're doing. And I'm not really used to that, so. Again, guys, I'm proud. Beast has been the dog that's ran up my last two rabbits. Every rabbit this year I've killed here at home. That's weird, as many places I've been, but it's true. This is the rabbit. Let me check the sex. As you can see, he's been attacked before. His ear is split, so he's been fighting, or he's just been launched up in some bushes. Yeah, heart shot, head shot, heart shot, chest shot. It was a short range shot, so I really didn't think it would hit him, but he flattened and he just went to jumping. He's still hot. This feels like a male, guys. His penis is right here. And it's right next to his tail. It's still covered in fleas. If you push down side it, you ought to be able to feel the testicles up on the inside. But I don't know. It's possibly a female. I'm still going to have to hone up on my skills with that. Let me go catch Beast and I will come back with a video of this puppy. See you guys in a few. Here we go, guys. About to play with this puppy, son, this rabbit. Pretty good. Like I said, he's been in the training pen before. So he knows all about rabbits and how they smell and how they run and all this goodies and goddies. Instead of giving, I might give Beast some of it, but I might give most of it to him today. Good job. Good boy. Come on. Let's go back to pin. Go. Good little dog. Well, guys, that's my video for today. I will post it later. Right now, I just got to go do some skinning and take it, let my nephew see it, or he will die. Thank you guys for watching. Alright, everybody. I got him hung up. I'm getting ready to start skinning him. Usually, when I kill a rabbit, I give them to my dogs. Give the skin to the dogs. And it's just a part of the reward. I might give a piece to Beast, since he is the dog that ended up running him. But since the puppy's new, I'm gonna take and dry the skin out. And whenever, instead of being able to have to pay all the time for taking to a training pen, I'll always have a skin that I can just run around in the yard with him and work with him some. After about 2 weeks of me messing with him in this skin, maybe 2 months, I'll give him maybe a month. I ain't gonna say 2 weeks, it's kind of short notice. He ought to be able to, I ought to be able to tie the skin next to the pen overnight or during the day, all day. And then one evening just come out here and turn it, take it loose and just drag it until I turn it into the field. Like pull it from the pen all the way into the field. And by then he ought to be able to start learning how to work with his nose. Instead of always sight running and sight working with it. So it's just another guess. People told me that it works pretty good for rabbit dogs and puppies. So I've never had to train one myself, so I'm going to work with it like that. Here is, guys, last look. Again, thank you for watching me.